Assalamu alaikum, hello and namaste. Welcome to another inspiring episode number 44 of The Limelight. Today, we have a sweet and smart Radhika Marwaha. She has just finished her 12th. Her interests are creative writing and poetry, debating, especially at forums like the Model United Nations. She also likes baking, art, playing the electronic keyboard, and many more. She was the head girl of the student council in her school, and now she has earned her seat for biomedical engineering and major in literature at the prestigious University of California, Davis. So, listeners, please welcome our sweet Radhika Marwaha.
Hello.
Hello. How are you doing today?
Oh, I'm good.
Welcome to the show, dear.
Thank you so much.
So, Radhika, before we get into know more about you, I want you to tell our listeners about your personal life.
I've been living in Dubai since I was born. So that's like 17 years now.
Okay.
And I live with my parents and my younger sister, Ria. She's in 9th grade. Now, as you mentioned, my hobbies include painting, poetry, reading books, and etc. Okay. I'm little low-key on food, but I love trying out new things to eat. And I like watching TV, and I feel that talking is my biggest facet.
That's interesting.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And I pray that God blesses you and your family with all the health, happiness in life.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome, dear. So, Radhika, tell me, how was your experience of being the head girl of the student council?
First of all, as the saying goes, uneasy lies the head that wears the crown. It wasn't like, I wouldn't say it was the best experience ever, or it was very easy or something like that, because planning events like a farewell or like a teacher's day assembly is taxing, of course. Okay. But that gave me the platform to work on my leadership skills and also gave me a chance to let out my creative side. Apart from that, it taught me how to balance my life, because meeting deadlines for assignments and having to finish decoration for, let's say, a winter carnival when finals were just around the corner was something that was really challenging, and I think that kept me driving as well.
Yeah, right. As a student, when you have challenges, it gives the best out of you. That's what
exactly.
I believe. And it improves your skills for the future.
Yeah. Pressure is very important to keep you driving and get the best out of you.
Yes, exactly. Now, what are your future plans?
Just like any other student who is in high school, I thought, okay, I should apply to the topmost colleges, and once I get there, I'll get the best job, and then I'll have the best life ever.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what all of us think, right?
Right.
So in September, like towards August, September, I started my college applications.
Mm-hmm.
All these months, like once I applied and started getting back responses from various colleges,
mm-hmm.
the main thing I realized was that as a student, I have to be alert at all times.
Okay.
Now, what this means is that just going for a lot of activities and scoring in your tests in school is not where it stops.
Mm-hmm.
Once you go to your counselor with your portfolio and ask them that, okay, come on, which colleges should I apply to?
Mm-hmm.
You cannot leave your life in the hands of the counselor.
Okay.
Because it's your life. You have to drive it your way.
Mm-hmm.
So the most important thing is you have to be careful that your counselor takes as much interest in your life as you do.
Mm-hmm.
You need to keep asking your counselor, which courses should I apply to? Which course should I take so that I have the best shot of getting into the college I want to go to? You need to make sure that every aspect of your portfolio is being used properly in your application. Like, if you've done some activity but it is being left out, that is not fair.
Mm-hmm, right.
So it's really important that you are like up to date with whichever application you have to fill, your deadlines are met properly, and the only person who can do that is, like, you know, the student yourself.
Yeah.
Not your parents, not your teachers, not your counselors.
That's true. And what do you think are the criteria, like, if someone wants to study abroad,
Yeah.
And from when they have to start the applications, or from when they have to literally start doing the activities for this?
Yeah, so I think that it should be a very continuous effort. So you cannot wake up suddenly in 11th and say, okay, I want to start doing some activities, because 11th is as already very academically challenging. Mm-hmm. So it has to be probably like the 8th grade or the 9th grade. You need to start getting on your track by that time. So small activities, like the most important thing is pick one activity and excel in it like nobody ever has. Be the best at one thing, but be so good that nobody can be as good as you. Mm-hmm. So 9th grade is like the time when you should start. Mm-hmm. You should make sure that you pick one field and take every possible opportunity and, you know, show your best of your skills.
Okay. Right, right. And by activities, you mean like in sports or in elocution, or what exactly you mean by activities?
Okay, so maybe you could pick one sport that you really like. And the next thing you could do is, like I did, Model United Nations. Mm-hmm. That is a great forum. Like when your college application has that, it would show that you take interest not only in the issues that surround you, but all around the world. So that's a great thing. Okay. Or if somebody is interested in playing an instrument or singing, anything. The most important thing is that once you start focusing on your activities, you need to make sure that your grades don't drop, because at the end of the day, you're going to study in a college, right?
Right, exactly. So they have to see that when they prepare themselves for university abroad, they have to start getting good grades as well as concentrating on activities and balancing with their studies also.
Exactly. So it's a really taxing effort, because you don't know what to involve yourself in, but at the same time, you have to maintain that balance.
Okay. Now, I have something interesting for you here.
Okay.
And this is called the rapid fire round.
Yeah.
I will be asking you 4 random questions.
Okay.
And you can answer that in one word or a sentence. Okay.
Okay.
The first question is, which is your favorite book?
I don't know. I love reading all sorts of books, but I think Inferno by Dan Brown.
Nice, nice one.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Second, one of your favorite memory.
My favorite memory was when my sister was born.
Oh, how cute. That's really nice.
Yeah.
One habit you wish you could change?
I wish I could become more serious at times, because I like to take everything in a very easygoing manner. Mm-hmm. But that makes people take me very easily. So I need to get a little more stern, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So I'm trying to work on that.
The last question. If you were given a chance to swap your life with another girl or a lady, who would it be?
Emma Watson, any day.
Wow, that's nice. Okay, that was the end of the rapid fire round, and you did great.
Thank you.
Though I don't have a hamper for you, but it was lovely. The answers were great.
Yeah.
Okay, now we have headed to the last segment of our show, where we ask your advice.
I would just like to say one thing, that in today's world, self-drive is the most important thing. Mm-hmm. You need to motivate yourself, and unless you have 100% belief in yourself, nobody is going to motivate you to exceed your potential. Everybody is going to come and say, it's okay, but that's not how life goes on. So you have to make sure that you also have amazing friends with you in your journey, because they can really get you through some crazy times in life and make sure that the best in you comes out always.
Yes, that was superb and lovely advice, especially from a little teenager like you, where this kind of mentality must be there in all the kids and teenagers. And Radhika, I thank you so much for taking time and coming to our show and sharing your journey, and all the best to you, dear.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
You're welcome, dear. Listeners, if you have liked this interview, please click on the like button of the Limelight page. and thank you for listening. Allah Hafiz.